If you are a PC gamer looking to buy a mid-tier GPU, then I will be straight with you. The upcoming 16GB version of the RTX 4060 Ti, which is priced at $499, most likely this is not the GPU for you. However, if you happen to be a content creator, a skilled video editor, or even a fellow YouTuber like myself, this GPU becomes an entirely different story. In fact, the 16GB RTX 4060 Ti could be the most compelling sub-$500 GPU option available for those involved in content creation. So let's talk about this GPU. This video is brought to you by scdkey.com, where you can purchase Windows 10 Pro OEM keys for only $15.77. Use the link in the video description below to purchase Windows 10 Pro or Windows 10 Home OEM keys, and don't forget to use my 25% coupon code TP25. To activate your Windows license, press and hold Windows key plus S and type activation settings in the search box. Next, click on change product key at the bottom of the page and paste your newly purchased Windows 10 Pro OEM key. Wait for a few minutes and boom! Your Windows 10 Pro is now fully activated. And by the way, you can always upgrade to Windows 11 Pro for free. You can also get Microsoft Office 2019 and various other PC games. So check the links that I've put in the video description below. And now let's get back to the video. Okay, before talking about RTX 4060 Ti, let's first talk about RTX 4060, which is priced at $299. In all honesty, one could argue that this card should have been named RTX 4050, considering Nvidia's decision to decrease its VRAM from 12GB, as seen in the RTX 3060, to a mere 8GB. But they also decreased the price. In fact, the cheapest RTX 3060 card that I can find in the market as of today, it's costing around $40 more than RTX 4060. So I think RTX 4060 will be a great entry-level GPU for folks who are just starting out with basic 4K video editing. What sets it apart from similarly priced AMD and Intel GPUs is the inclusion of the 8th generation Nvidia NVENC encoder. This is the same encoder that you will find in higher tier Nvidia GPUs, and it supports the latest AV1 codec. So this means you can work with cutting-edge video formats while experiencing improved encoding and decoding performance. But when it comes to gaming, there are some uncertainties surrounding the performance of RTX 4060. It might be wise to hold off and consider waiting for the AMD Radeon RX 7600, which is expected to be similarly priced but potentially offer better rasterization performance than RTX 4060. Now, Nvidia claims that RTX 4060 is approximately 20% faster than the RTX 3060, but I will take these claims with a grain of salt. Nvidia's own benchmark appears somewhat misleading because in their comparison charts, they showcase RTX 4060 frame rates with DLSS 3.0 enabled. The actual performance difference between the RTX 4060 and the RTX 3060 is likely to be in the single digits. Moreover, the reduction in video RAM from 12GB to 8GB is going to be a big disappointment. With many new gaming titles requiring increasingly higher amounts of video RAM, especially when aiming to crank up the resolution and graphics setting, I think this reduction in memory could pose serious limitations. Now let's talk about the RTX 4060 Ti. Personally, I believe it's best to overlook the 8GB model of this GPU, as it simply does not justify its $400 price tag. One of the main concerns with this variant is its narrow 128-bit memory bus and the limited 8GB of VRAM. As a result, it appears like a modest upgrade over the RTX 3060 Ti. So here is the benchmark result that Nvidia shared. You can clearly see that the titles where RTX 4060 Ti appears to be ahead are actually DLSS 3.0 enabled benchmarks. In my opinion, these charts are a bit misleading when evaluating pure rasterization performance. While there are some improvements, I don't think RTX 4060 Ti is a groundbreaking generational leap card. Interestingly, Nvidia is now largely positioning the 8GB version of the RTX 4060 Ti as a 1080p gaming card. I think this is an implicit acknowledgement that 8GB VRAM is not sufficient for playing modern gaming titles at maximum setting on a 1440p resolution. However, to give credit where it's due, Nvidia did increase the L2 cache from 4MB to 32MB in the RTX 4060 Ti. A larger cache allows for storing frequently used instructions and textures, which reduce the number of times the GPU needs to access the VRAM. This improvement should help mitigate some of the disadvantages of the narrower 128-bit memory bus. Now, NVIDIA claims that this additional cache boosts the effective memory bandwidth from 288 to 554 gigabytes per second. But again, I will take this claim with a grain of salt. In fact, NVIDIA doesn't even tell us how exactly are they calculating this effective memory bandwidth. They show this chart and they try to explain why the, you know, increased cache will somehow double the memory bandwidth, but it's not very clear to me. So honestly, I would skip this card and wait for the arrival of the 16 gigabyte version of RTX 4060 Ti. Now, as a content creator and a video editor myself, I am really looking forward to the 16 gigabyte version of RTX 4060 Ti. The standout feature of this card is obviously the 16 gig VRAM, because until now, if you wanted an NVIDIA 40 series RTX GPU with 16 gig VRAM, you had to shell out around $1,200 for the RTX 4080. Even the RTX 4070 Ti and the RTX 4070 came with only 12 gig of VRAM. So if you are a content creator, the 16 gigabyte version of RTX 4060 Ti, it looks like a perfect $500 video card. In fact, the 16 gigabyte version of RTX 4060 Ti effectively renders RTX 4080, RTX 4070 Ti, and RTX 4070 obsolete for the majority of content creators. Of course, folks who are doing advanced 3D animation in Blender, they will still go with RTX 4090 or 4080 because these cards offer much, much faster performance, and RTX 4090 comes with 24GB of VRAM. But there is one problem. Despite boasting double the VRAM compared to RTX 3060 Ti, it is using a puny 128-bit memory bus. Remember, the last generation RTX 3060 Ti had a memory bandwidth of 448 gigabytes per second, despite coming with only 8GB of VRAM. This was because it came equipped with a 256-bit memory bus. Now, to understand how badly this affects the performance of RTX 4060 Ti, we first need to understand the significance of the memory bus size. So picture it as a bustling highway with multiple lanes. The more lanes dedicated to traffic, the smoother the traffic flow. So RTX 4060 Ti with 128-bit memory will typically use 4 memory chips, since each memory chip has a 32-bit wide bus. Since each memory chip offers 2GB of VRAM, 4 memory chips will only give you a total of 8GB VRAM. So the next question is, how is NVIDIA managing to put 16GB VRAM in this GPU? So what NVIDIA is doing is actually very clever. It's called memory clamshelling. Basically, NVIDIA puts 4 2GB memory chips on each side of the PCB. So effectively, there are 4 pairs of 2GB memory chips sharing the same memory controllers and the same 128-bit memory bus. NVIDIA has employed this technique in the past to double the VRAM in RTX 3090 from 12GB to 24GB. Take a look at this image showcasing the front side of the RTX 3090 PCB. Right in the center, you spot the GA102 graphics chip, which is surrounded by 12 memory chips, each with a capacity of 1GB. Flip the PCB over and you see an additional 12 memory chips on the back. Effectively, there are 12 pairs of memory chips, all sharing the 12 memory controllers and the 384-bit memory bus. So this implementation has allowed NVIDIA to achieve the impressive 24GB VRAM capacity without needing to resort to major design overhauls or additional memory controllers. So this is memory clamshelling, and it works great on RTX 3090 because that card had a wide 384-bit memory bus. So that allowed for efficient data transfer, and that did not create any kind of bottleneck. But with a narrow 128-bit memory bus on the RTX 4060 Ti, there is a legitimate concern that the memory clamshelling arrangement on this GPU, it may not work as efficiently. The constrained bandwidth could potentially limit the overall effectiveness of sharing memory across 8 chips. Now, NVIDIA was anticipating this criticism, so they countered by making the argument that 32 megabytes of L2 cache will be more than enough to compensate for the narrow memory bus. In fact, in their charts, NVIDIA claims that RTX 4060 Ti would offer an effective bandwidth of 554 gigabytes per second, which is even higher than what RTX 3060 Ti was offering. That was 448 gigabytes per second. And remember, that GPU had 256-bit memory bus. Now, how much of this is actually true and how much of this is just marketing bullshit from Nvidia? I don't know. I think we will find out when these cards get released. Of course, alternatives like the Radeon RX 6800 or even the RX 6800 XT can be found today for under $500, and these cards offer 16GB of VRAM. Additionally, Intel's Arc A770 offers 16GB of VRAM, and that card goes for under $350. However, when it comes to performance and reliability, these cards simply cannot compete with Nvidia. A quick glance at the Puget Bench DaVinci Resolve score paints a compelling picture. In content creation workloads, Nvidia clearly dominates AMD and Intel. Now, personally, as a user of DaVinci Resolve for video editing, I can attest to the superiority of Nvidia CUDA cores over those of AMD and Intel. The difference in performance is stark, and Nvidia's CUDA cores outshine the competition by a significant margin. Whether you like it or not, right now for content creation, Nvidia is the king. Another crucial factor that sets Nvidia apart is the stability of their drivers. While both AMD and Intel drivers can be prone to flakiness and they have a tendency to crash Adobe Premiere and even DaVinci Resolve, Nvidia's studio drivers remain rock solid. In fact, I have personally experienced zero crashes while using Nvidia GPUs for video editing for the last 3 years. It has been an amazingly stable platform. This level of reliability allows me to focus on my work without interruptions or frustrations, and I think that's the most important thing for content creators. The last thing you want is that your PC crashes or hangs. So overall, I feel the 16GB version of the RTX 4060 Ti presents an exceptional value proposition for content creators and for video editors. With its ample VRAM, it bridges the gap between high-end offerings and the more affordable offerings, making it an attractive choice at the $500 price point. Nvidia's dominance in performance, especially in applications like DaVinci Resolve, coupled with their reliability and stable drivers, solidify their position as the go-to brand for content creators seeking a seamless and powerful editing experience. Now, I might sound like Nvidia shill, but you know, I'm just stating the truth. Right now, Nvidia is the best platform for video editing, unless you want to use MacBooks, right? But that's a different thing. Apple is on a completely different planet. If you are on a PC and if you want to pick Nvidia, Intel, or AMD, Nvidia wins. So what do you guys think about RTX 4060 Ti? I would love to hear your thoughts on whether the 16GB version of this card, whether it's a worthwhile purchase or whether it's garbage. Let me know if you mostly game on your GPU or if you guys use it for live streaming, you know, editing videos and doing some content creation. Also tell me what price point would you consider to be the maximum that you are willing to pay for RTX 4060 Ti. Feel free to share all your opinions in the comment section below. By the way, if you are in the market for a GPU specifically for video editing and budget is not a concern, I highly recommend that you check this video over here. In this video, I dive deep into the latest Puget Bench results, providing an in-depth analysis of the video editing performance between the RTX 4090 and the RX 7900 XTX. So go ahead and watch that video, and I will see you guys over there. Bye!